Hi, I'm Cameron McKenzie at CameronMCNZ on Twitter, and I wanted to talk to you about how you can do some web scraping and move that to Excel. I did a couple of tutorials that were fairly popular on doing web scraping itself, and in this example, I'm going to take that example one step further and take the results and save it to an Excel file. So, like always, I'll start this off by creating a new process, and I'll call it Best Buy Screen Scraper. Because I've got some stuff I want to buy over at Best Buy. I've been looking for a watch. I'm really looking for a discount on a Garmin watch. Really love Garmins. And I'm looking for one that's on sale. And specifically, it has to be a Garmin watch. And you can see this is a list of all the Garmin watches on sale over at Best Buy. And I like to sort them by price as well, from high to low. I like to dream of having a Phoenix 6S. Anyways, I'd like to automate kind of scraping this page and gathering all this data so that I don't have to go to the page every single day, that the page will come to me, maybe through an email. And so the way you do that is through screen scraping. Watch this. I'm going to copy the URL that's up here, and then I'm going to come to UiPath, open the main workflow window, and say, you know what? I want to do some data scraping. So I click data scraping. The tool comes up and it says, okay, what do you want to scrape? And I want to grab all of the information here about all these Garmin watches that are for sale. I'd like to, you know, maybe run this once a day and then see if there's any new items for sale. And so you highlight, well, I want to highlight the whole range here that encompasses an entire watch, the price, the link, the image. And then it says, okay, well, there's the start one. What does the finish item look like in this list? And there's the finish one right there. I'll click next. I'll try and highlight the same amount of data for the finish one. And it'll say, fantastic, we've got these two columns here. And I guess I'll call the first column Garmin item and the second column the URL. And then the other thing I can do is I can extract maybe some extra data. And you can see there the list of the Garmin items are being pulled out there, all the information that's really important. And over on the right-hand side, it's the URL to get to the item. But really what I'm interested in is the price, right? I want to know if there's been any price drop or any price change. So you can also click this extract correlated data. And so you can kind of go dig deeper inside of the web page, inside of the item. And the item that I really want is I want that price, right? I want to keep track of what the price of these items are. I want you to pick it in the first one and then pick the corresponding one in the second one, corresponding location. There's the price right there. And then it's figured all of that stuff out, and then I'll say that's the sale price. I'll click the next button, and then you can see that the whole data from this page has now been extracted into this data table. So I think that I'm finished here. I've got the product. I've got all of the information on it. Identify the element that navigates the next pages. Well, there's no next page here, because sometimes you might have a pagination, right? Like, click this button for more, go to page two. There's none of that there. That's all the items on the page. So I don't need to indicate any pagination there. And then from here, this is going to extract all of that data. It's all get puts into a data table called extract data table. And if I want to gain access to that information, well, I could just write that to an Excel file. I could send the data in an email. I think for right now, it'd just be nice to loop through that data and take a look at it. And so the for each row activity will allow you to do this. Don't pick the for each activity. Very different. It won't cast the object into a row and it'll cause problems. Here I want to use the for each row activity and say, you know, for each row, well, let's just extract some data for it. So I'll do some right line here. And in this case, I can get row at 0.toString. And then maybe just, well, I've got three rows here, so I'll take all three. And of course, instead of row 0, I'll do row 1, and I'll do row 2. And I'm going to run this application. Make sure that, well, first of all, I'll make sure that there's no errors. Yeah, that looks like it's all good. And I will run this application, and you will see it's going to go onto that page, do a little bit of scraping. And then finally here in this console, you'll see all of the information that I wanted. The name of the product and all the details, plus the sale price for the item, plus the URL, all of that comes nice and handsomely onto the page. Now, if you want to take this example one step further, what you could do is actually write the results to Excel. So at this point in time, when we've scraped the data, we've got all of this data in this extract data table object. We can actually write that to Excel fairly easily. Now, this project is called Best Buy Screen Scrape. I'm going to go into the Best Buy Screen Scrape project folder, and I'm going to create a new Excel file. And I'll call it Scrape Data. I'm going to copy that name because I'm going to need that right now, because at the bottom of this page, and I want to make sure that I'm outside of the for loop. I'm going to zoom in just a little bit here. Just after the for loop completes, what I want to do is I want to add an Excel activity. And there's the Excel application scope activity just outside. You see that blue line there? That's the end of the loop. And what I want to do in here is connect to that Excel file that I just created, and then append all of that data that's in that data table to that Excel file. And so all of that data was stored in a data table named Extract Data Table. You can see it declared right there. And if I specify that as the data table to append, what will happen now is when this runs, we'll not only scrape the data, print it out to the console, but we'll actually have all of that data written into this Excel file. And so let's run this program one more time. Probably see the Excel file flash as they open that up. I'll go back into the project, open up the Excel file, and look at that. All of the information is now in this file. We've got all of the data scraped from the entire element, plus then we've got the URL, and then after that, we've got specifically the price that something is on sale. And we wanted to write a little program that, you know, maybe extracted Phoenix 6X from here and looked at the price. You know, we could easily have an application that monitors this file and keeps looking to see what the current price of the Phoenix 6X is. And there you go. That's how you can actually do the screen scraping and then write the results to Excel. And there you go. That's how easy it is to web scrape data and save it to Excel. If you enjoyed that tutorial, why don't you head over to theserverside.com. I'm the editor-in-chief over there. We got lots of great tutorials, lots of great articles on enterprise software. If you're interested in my personal antics, follow me on Twitter at CameronMCNZ and subscribe on YouTube.